My name is Judy Rose, and this is a concert choir. I just wanted to let you know that there are going to be a few changes in the order, and we have one omission, which is a jubilant day. And if you just came to hear that piece, I'm sorry. I know you didn't. But anyhow, so we just did Let the River Run, and then we're going to sing The Eyes of All, and then we're going to sing Veni Sancte Spiritus, and we will have Dylan Heimbach. Yes, conducting. I'd love to get names correct. And then we will sing Keep Your Lamps, which Cesare will be conducting. So sit back, enjoy, and thank you for coming.
Thank you. and she brings us news of the harvest, of the barley, wheat, and corn, and she knows when we'll go to our graves, and how we shall be born. One's for sorrow, two's for joy.
Bye. Thank you for coming out tonight. It is great to see so many of you here. We decided we'd do something a little bit different. We haven't done that this year, but we're so close to Halloween that we thought we'd do kind of a little Halloween treat for you. And so we've spared no expense at the Dollar Tree to create. What we wanted to do was create the sound and the visual effects from the ride, The Haunted Mansion at Disney. And there are some singing busts that are in there that sing a thing called Grim Grinning Ghosts. Now, the thing is, we haven't been able to do it before because we haven't had these, which are low basses. Basses that don't come along very often. So this is really a chance to show these guys off, and I call them the squatches, but it is so fun to be able to do this piece. So if you'll allow us a minute here, we're going to throw some technical wizardry at you and do Grim Grinning Ghosts. Completely different. Thank you. Thank you. When we were searching for a theme for tonight's concert, I originally, kind of over the summer, was thinking about the conflict that continues to go on in the world, and I had selected this next piece, Can We Sing the Darkness to Light? Now, oddly enough, that first piece by William Byrd is someone who grew up and worked under great persecution in England, and we're celebrating the 400th anniversary this year of his death. He was English Renaissance's greatest composer. And he was a Catholic recusant who was protected in a newly Episcopal nation, the Church of England, he was also really great friends with Queen Elizabeth. So she took care of him, gave him his own estate, and gave him all the rights to sheet music paper publishing in England. And so he lived out a long and illustrious career, oddly enough, with many of his pieces appearing both in Latin and then later also in English. But he lived a life seeing people around him burned at the stake and murdered, and a lot of his motets that come from that period are quite intense. This latest one, not so much. It's more happy and upbeat, and it seemed the best way to start our set off rather than going fully emo right from the beginning. This next piece, then, by Kyle Peterson, is even more poignant after the events that took place, frankly, on October 7th, where the world continues to find itself at war with each other. I hope you'll enjoy us singing this text for you, Can We Sing the Darkness to Light? I think it's a thing that we as musicians do. When things get rough, we make music more intensely and with greater devotion than we ever have. So we're happy to present this piece to you. lost one of the Pacific music family. Her name was Santa Zake, and she was our music librarian. And she had been here all the years I've been here, which is 36, and she'd been here before I got here. We were able to sing a little bit for her right as we came back. But a few weeks ago, we had the pleasure of seeing one of the library wings, the music library, dedicated to Santa. And we prepared this piece for that ceremony, and we'd like to sing it for you now. This is a beautiful piece by Stephen Paulus entitled The Road Home, and it features our soloist, Sude Longworth. I always wanted for us to be able to do a setting of this next text. It's a setting that I think is very apropos, even more so these days. This is a setting of Bob Dylan's The Times They Are A-Changin'.
Thank you.
Chance, or if you haven't had a chance, the poem to this next one is one of the most excruciatingly beautiful poems I've ever read in my life. And I read it this summer, thought, we've got to do this. So it is by, the poetry is by Pablo Neruda, a Chilean poet and statesman who lived through an amazingly difficult time. The setting is by one of my mentors. His name is Morten Lordson. Lordson was originally from Oregon. He went to Sunset High School, but he was my music theory teacher when I was in college at USC. He became the greatest, and is still the greatest living composer, from the choral composer from the late 20th and early 21st century. I still stay in contact with him, and in fact, the very first recording of his music ever was done here on this stage in 1993. Which put him on the map, the Lordson Choral Cycles, and so we recorded them here when the hall was brand new. So it seemed very fitting to put all of these things together and sing this incredible, beautiful piece, Soneto de la Noche.
Thank you.
Before we sing our last piece, we want to thank you all so much for joining us on this beautiful, beautiful fall evening for an evening of choral music. We're so happy you're here, and we look forward to seeing you at other concerts. This last piece, Shane O, will kind of explain itself, but it's sort of related to the last piece that Vera Voce did. And this is, again, coming out of the Celtic tradition of mouth music. And it seemed that both in Ireland and in Scotland, when England threatened the people, they took their instruments away. And as a result, people said, "We can't do that. We make sounds like instruments with our own mouths." And so we'll explain as we go all of our way through that this is a point of defiance, speaking to authority and saying, you can't conquer music. It lives on, the music of the people. We now present to you Shane O.
Pipe tunes live on for a better day.
Eagle!